let's talk about storytelling. As old as the hills. It's the most ancient form of communication, and it is done today everywhere. And people often say to me, but I don't have a story. Well, of course you have a story. Everyone has a story. And if you watch advertising, the ones that hold your attention are the ones with really strong stories attached. Christmas, that's their whole reason for doing advertising. They put stories together. And even if you look at ones that seem to be advertising just a product, if you look carefully enough, you will see how that has its own story. And the way stories are put together is as simple as this. Okay, so let me start with this recording. This morning, I'm recording a message for you out there. Let's expand this. I woke up this morning and decided today was the day I would do a video broadcast on storytelling for you. Then we expand it a bit more. I had to get up this morning because I was woken by the doorbell, which happened to be the postman with a new pair of boots for me. And having put the boots on and feeling, you know, like you do with new shoes, I decided I would do a video broadcast to talk to you about storytelling. Now, that's our opening. That's the beginning of any story once upon a time. So let me now expand into the bit in a story that we love, the difficulty in a story. So this morning I got woken up by the postman, and he had my new boots that I'd ordered. Very excited. So I got dressed, I got myself ready, and I put my new boots on. The problem was, with all new boots, all new shoes, they're quite tight. And I struggled to actually get my foot, you know, if you bend your foot into the shoe. But I kept at it. Normally I would ask hubby to help, but he's away. I finally get my boots on and I am feeling great. And I strut around the flat with my new boots on. And then an idea comes to me. The idea being that I needed to do a video broadcast and tell the story, the simple story of my boots and how you can wield and weave storytelling into anything. We have our story now. We have the once upon a time. We have the agony and the worry of the getting the boots on. We have the triumph. And finally we have the lives happily ever after. And that is, I am wearing my boots and I feel great. I have done my video and I'm going to go away and visit my mum today. Short, sharp and sweet. Now if I'd said to you, oh, I got a new pair of boots this morning, you'd have all gone, so what? And trust me, for a speaker, that phrase, so what, you do not want to hear. So by weaving that story together, that really simple story, it was easier for me to hold your attention about a pair of boots you really don't care about, because they're not your boots, they're my boots. But that's how storytelling works. It's how you add to that story, how you just plump it out like a pillow for people to really engage and listen to, because the brain loves stories. Really does. You now know how I woke up this morning. You now know who was at the door this morning. You now know what I received this morning. You now know how I felt about it. You also now know how difficult it was to get those boots on. And you know that I'm a person who doesn't give up, not when it comes to new boots. So I want you to think about that whenever you think I don't have a story, or you're trying to put words together for content or for a video or for anything. Start with a simple statement and start plumping it out just like you would your pillows or your cushions. Okay, that's all from me today, and I really hope that helps. Don't forget, any questions, all the W's, bevhepting.com. You can email me, bev@bevhepting.com. Look on social media, I'm all over the place. I'm a bit of a tart on social media. I hope it helps, and I will talk to you again soon. Okay, bye!